Компания Artec была создана в 2007.
Artec Group was founded in 2007. A year later, the company completed the development of its product, a three-dimensional scanner, and planned to raise funds with the help of venture investors. But the global financial crisis broke out, making spare funds scarce. The company was left to its own resources.
Артем Юхин, Андрей Климов, Глеб Гусев и Сергей Сухов.
Артем Юхин, Андрей Климов, Глеб Гусев and Сергей Сухов have been working together for the past 10 years. Their most successful project was the A4 Vision, a company specializing in biometrics. They set the biometric standards and helped create biometric passports. A4 Vision raised $35 million of investment through foreign venture capital funds.
Что российским начинающим компаниям удается крайне редко.
Few Russian startups have achieved anything like this. Later, they managed to sell the company to a strategic investor, the Canadian Bioscript company. The investments brought profit. After that, the Russian businessmen decided to invest in the creation of the three-dimensional scanners for the mass market. This is how the Artec company came about.
Основали компанию, поклялись, что мы больше никогда не будем заниматься.
We got tired from all of these biometric police applications. We wanted to work with art, archaeology, film industry, medicine, and so we have found Artec.
The three-dimensional scanners available at the time were not designed for the mass market. They were expensive, bulky, slow, and sometimes required extra knowledge to operate. Artec wanted to solve all these problems.
Он может увидеть только какой-то кусочек поверхности, такую скорлупку.
It can only see one side of the object. Then you have to change the position of the object or the scanner so as to scan each side. It takes ages to make a 3D model. We are used to being able to rotate something in our computers and see it from all sides. That is what we call 3D. Our scanner can do this much faster. It does not require turning the objects around. It doesn't require turning the object around.
Despite a fair amount of experience in three-dimensional scanning, the development of equipment and image processing algorithm took a long time. Prototypes were completed by 2008. Venture investments were needed to launch the production and to start sales. Then, the global financial crisis broke out. Many investment programs were cut short. Investors now demanded more for their money, in this case, the greater share in the company. The team did not want to lose their project a second time around and decided to make do without external investment. They started saving up on everything they could and selling small batches of scanners. This business model is called bootstrapping.
Bootstrapping в буквальном переводе с английского затягивание пояса.
Bootstrapping means running a business without external help or capital. As a rule, it requires reducing costs and starting sales immediately.
Это путь, который во многом хороший, потому что он сразу.
It is a good approach. This way you know right away whether the business will float, whether the product will sell. It will not let a company spend the investor's money over 2 or 3 years only to discover that there's no demand for the product.
It was a tough decision to make, though not too risky. The founders understood that with proper planning, even their scarce funds should be enough.
Почему мы так поступили? Потому что.
Why did we do it? Because when it comes to investments, you always need to decide which risks to take on yourself and which to share with the investors. In our case, we were very sure that our product would work, and we knew how much time it needed to take off. We were a little nervous at first, of course, but our decision ended up being justified.
But this didn't become clear until later. First, they needed funds. The only way to get them was by selling scanners, and that's where the trouble began.
Нам пришлось продавать.
We needed to sell our scanners, but we were not ready yet. We had never supplied end users before, only major security system companies. And now we had actual live customers to consider: physicians, archaeologists, museum workers, and plastic surgeons.
Lack of experience didn't make things worse. Employees note that one of the strategic decisions in the beginning of sales was not to provide the distributors with free samples.
If you are selling a sample, customers want to get their money's worth. They will milk the product for all it's got.
A product received by a reseller for free would probably lie on the store shelf, packed up and hidden from possible buyers. The distributor always wants to sell the products he's already paid for. So a fledgling company should not give out free samples, since time is crucial for the survival of a young business. Also, Artec managed to avoid another common mistake made by bootstrapping companies. The company did not give up exclusive rights, which would have led to a monopoly and consequently lower sales.
Comfortable terms and a trustful relationship make everybody, good or bad, professional or not, ease up a little bit. That should not happen.
6 months later, the company earned its initial investment and passed the critical point. It was time to move away from bootstrapping methods.
It went like this. A company rented a small office in our building. They were saving money. Eventually, they needed more space. Their room had high ceilings, so they built a number of the little shelves and hooks and pulleys so as to use all the space at their disposal, not just the floor space. That's how multi-story buildings first appeared in the Middle Ages. We just had the same thing happen in one of the rooms in our building.
The scanner was too expensive for most potential buyers, but has been demanded by specialists in many sectors. Artec 3D scanners are, for example, used in plastic surgery. They allow the doctor to create a three-dimensional image of the patient's face or body part in just a few minutes. Lightweight scanners are also used by archaeologists and museum workers.
We had this interesting case once. An Italian archaeologist bought our scanner. He dug up layer by layer, each from different age, and he needed to record them. And then he needed to put it all back, because the museum had no storage space.
Scanners like those help museums create virtual excursions, like the ones in the Louvre and the Hermitage. All the user needs is a computer connected to the internet. The technology allows producers to make accurate copies of any tourist attraction for souvenirs. The subject that is being replicated just needs to be scanned, and then a program needs to be written that will manufacture the replica.
Сканеры, которые производят Artec, они попали в очень удачную нишу, связанную с тем, что для
Even though Artec scanners were far from the first on the market, they obtained their own niche because they were easier to use than some of the other well-known 3D scanners. For example, many 3D scanners require so-called markers, these shiny stickers that help identify the object.
Computer game developers and people from the film industry could very well be the next in line for Artec scanners, because the creation of a 3D character or landscape takes mere hours with the help of them. Other technologies take more time. Artec is also working its way towards the mass market, which it has dreamed of occupying from the very beginning.
There are a lot of ways of displaying 3D information, and it's all moving towards mass production. We want to make it possible for anybody to snap a 3D shot of himself or his friend or his cat and post it to the Facebook, and that there's an image which could be rotated and visible from all sides.
To make it user-friendly, however, the 3D scanner needs to become smaller. Right now, it's the size of a large video camera, and cheaper. Artec scanners are 2 to 3 times cheaper than their foreign analogs, but they are still too expensive for the majority of consumers. Their average scanner price is $15,000. The developers hope to lower the price by means of mass production.
It is simply a question of market volume. If the market is big enough, the devices will be produced in larger quantities. Then we could reduce price to $100 or $300 per scanner.
Artec continues working for security systems. A human face is as unique as a person's fingerprints. Glasses, a helmet, a fake beard, or more delicate disguises cannot trick the scanner.
2 years later, we came up with this camera. It can give you a 3D image of a face, like the A4 vision technologies, but it can also shoot anything, a panorama, a crowd. It can even make a dynamic 3D image of a crowd moving. Our partners saw this and said, yes, this is what we were waiting for. This is what you promised us.
Artec scanners work fast. People do not need to queue up to get scanned. This is particularly important in crowded places, for example, in airports.
A crowd is never safe. Same as if you have a locked door that takes ages to open. People will go around leaving it open, just propping it up with a stone or something. There won't be any security.
Sheremetyevo Airport in Moscow uses security systems based on Artec technology for staff identification. The airport houses representatives of many different companies, all with different levels of access. Scanners compare the person's face and their e-card with a database. After that, the system permits or forbids entrance. Artec founders hope that in the very near future, their technologies will help make the world a safer place.